Hey guys, it's Skylar. Do you know what today is? It's Christmas Story Day. Day 3. Haha! And we're reading The Elves and the Shoemaker today. That is the picture. So, that's the first picture. Alrighty. The Elves and the Shoemaker. There was once a shoemaker who, through no fault of his own, had become so poor that at last he had only leather enough left for one pair of shoes. It was the month before Christmas, when parties were starting to be held, and he planned a pair of dancing shoes for a young lady. In the evening, he cut out the shoes which he intended to begin upon the next morning, and then, feeling tired and worried, he lay down quietly, said his prayers, and fell asleep. In the morning, when he was preparing to sit down to work, he found the pair of shoes standing finished on his table. He was amazed and could not understand it in the least. He took the shoes in his hand to examine them more closely. They were so neatly sewn that not a stitch was out of place and were as good as the work of a master hand. Soon after that, a young girl came in and asked. She was so pleased with the shoes, she paid more than the ordinary price for them. So the shoemaker was able to buy leather. Good for him, right, guys? And those are her shoes. Let you guys see them more closely. Okay, this sentence is continued. So the shoemaker was able to buy leather for two pairs with the money. He cut them out in the evening, and next day, with fresh courage, was about to go to work, but he had no need to, for when he got up, the shoes were finished, and two more people eagerly bought them. That gave him so much money that he was able to buy leather for four pairs of shoes. Early next morning, he found the four pairs finished, and so it went on. What he cut out in the evening was finished in the morning. In a couple of weeks, the shoemaker was living very comfortably, with plenty of money for food and even enough to buy himself and his wife fine new clothes. Now, it happened on the day before Christmas, when he had cut out shoes that he said to his wife, "How would it be if we were to sit out tonight to see who it is that lends us such a helping hand?" His wife agreed, lit a candle, and then they both hid themselves in the corner of the room behind the clothes that were hanging there. At midnight, there came two little raggedy men who sat down at the shoemaker's table, took up the cutout work, and began with their tiny fingers to stitch, sew, and hammer so neatly and quickly that the shoemaker could not believe his eyes. They did not stop till everything was finished and stood complete on the table. Then they ran swiftly away. The next day, his wife said, "The little men have made us rich, and we ought to show them how grateful we are. Let us give them a Christmas present, for tomorrow is Christmas Day. I will make them little shirts, coats, waistcoats, and pants, and we'll even knit them strong socks, and you shall make them each a pair of shoes." The shoemaker agreed, and in the evening, when they had everything ready, they laid out the presents on the table with wine and cake, and hid themselves to see how the little men would behave. At midnight, they came skipping in and were about to set to work, but instead of the leather ready to cut out, they found the charming little clothes. At first they were surprised, then extremely delighted. With the greatest speed, they put on and smoothed down the pretty clothes, singing, "Now we're dressed so fine and neat, why cobble more for others' feet?" That's the picture. Then they drank the wine and ate the cake and hopped and danced about and leaped over the chairs and tables, and then out at the door. The next day was Christmas Day, and they did not appear, nor any day after that, but the shoemaker did well as long as he lived and had good luck in everything he did. and every Christmas Eve after that, he and his wife poured a glass of wine and drank a toast to their secret helpers. Alright guys, so that's it for today, and in yesterday's story, I showed you guys this picture, but I did not show you that picture, so sorry about that. So I'm just going to show you the pictures really quickly because I feel bad now. So this was from the first day I did this, Jesus is born in Bethlehem, that's one of the pictures. That's another one of the pictures. And that's it. I'm just getting to my place. I think you guys are going to love tomorrow's story too. So I hope you guys enjoyed this story. Please click like and subscribe, and I can't wait to read with you guys.